The Labrang Monastery sits in Xiahe County in northwest China's Gansu province. It's one of the six great temples of the Gulik school of Tibetan Buddhism, and also the home to the largest number of monks outside of Tibet. And it's here where the art of Tangka, said to be the history book of Tibetan culture, is so prominent. Siring Tongzhe, a Xiahe native, is a Tangka specialist. When we arrived at his studio, he was busy making paints for his next project. With the help of some glue, the Tangka's bright colors and luster can last for a long time. But before beginning to paint, Soring Tanju has a ritual. He always turns on music and tries to relax. After an eight-year apprenticeship, the 25-year-old opened his studio and began teaching others the finer points of the ancient art. When he left his master's studio at the beginning of last year, he was one of 10 apprentices. It was a proud moment when the master deemed him qualified to open his own studio. Siring Tongzhu grew up with a love for painting. His favorite class in school was art. In his eyes, the vast grasslands and flocks of sheep were the most wonderful things in the world. He would later spend quiet hours on the prairie painting while minding the livestock. In Tibetan areas, Tangka painters are highly respected, for this art mainly focuses on religious themes, usually depicting Buddhist deities and scenes, or the life of various influential lamas. As a nationally recognized art form, certain highly skilled Tangka artists have been cited as the future of the art. But why do Tibetans have such a fondness for Tangka? Most Tangka painters in Tibetan areas learn and pass down the art by following a master. Siring Tongzhu says it was more practical to learn from a master since he had received so little education. Through government support, especially tailored educational policies for Tibetan areas, school-aged children have the opportunity to study Tangka in school. As a result, the number who learn the art from a true master is shrinking. Schools in rural areas offer apprenticeships free of charge. There are also vocational programs devoted to teaching and spreading Tangka. Today, the art enjoys a diverse array of categories.
到现在的话是就是说各种唐卡的这个派别也比较多，西藏的唐卡它也是一种风格，而且这个青海的唐卡，然后咱们夏河的唐卡等等种类也比较多，但是大部分都是以宗教内容为题材的。Most
of Siring Tangzhu's creations capture religious themes. When painting, all artists use cotton cloth, wipe cornstarch on it, and polish it smooth after it's dry. But there are four different styles in terms of dyeing. The one with the bright colors is called Sai Tang. Black Tang expresses the angry Buddhist figures. There are also Red Tang and Golden Tang based on different background colors. While painting Tangka, it's necessary for artists to endure a state of solitude if they're to perfect their art. They spend entire days sitting alone in front of their paintings. Siring Tongzhu will allow no interruptions, no distractions. Sometimes, Si Ring Tongdra asks his wife to take care of the studio while he strolls to the nearby tea house or monastery. He says relaxation is important as it enables the mind to be rejuvenated, thus providing renewed inspiration and creativity. He's learned that nothing good can be created if the heart isn't calm. Directly adjacent to Si Ring Tongdra's room is his former master's studio. Apprentices are busy honing various techniques. The master artist says he never notices the passing of time as he paints. Yet for young people, he's observed a high degree of difficulty in concentration. Although Si Ring Tongdra and Dian Xin possess different styles, both generate a solid income through their studios. At the end of last year, a Tangka project commenced in Gansu province. More than 1,000 Tangka paintings are slated to be displayed, depicting historical sites, natural landscapes, and religious themes. And the study of Tangka is no longer a niche hobby for strictly art-minded individuals. It's become more popular throughout Tibetan society, even those with higher educational backgrounds. This is good news for Si Ring Tongdra. He believes the ancient art will have a bright future. Si Ring Tongdra endeavors to do his best in every painting. He says he plans to travel to bigger cities around China to promote Tangka after his skills reach a higher level. For him, such a splendid ethnic treasure should first be known and appreciated by his own compatriots, and then by the world.